I am Guru Raj from BHL. My question is to Srinivasan Thiagarajan of TCS. Did your solution also have a feature of generating sub schemes from the BOM?
Can I have the details of sub scheme means?
See, ultimately, for a control system supplier, the BOM also translates into a scheme, a wiring scheme. So, is that level of automation also possible?
Okay, so you are talking about the how do I explore the complete bill of material to the every level, right? Is it talking about wiring harness and control systems, mechanical, all those stuff?
Yes, mechanical drawings, yes. Electrical drawings. Yes.
Excellent. This is a very right question actually. I didn't get a time to actually showcase. We do have around 20 samples, something similar to what I have shown it for a pump. So you could use this one for a very detailed switch gears, e-hoses, galleys, and then cranes, the entire control systems of cranes. So any system, whether it is electrical or it is the mechanical or even if it is fluidic, even there are cases in which we use in the medical devices. So anything that is actually work with the knowledge-based engineering stuff that could actually automate this, and then you can get the defined output based on varying patterns of the requirements and specifications. Your question is answered, yes.
Yeah, but maybe the manufacturer also has to interact with you to develop the rules.
Yeah, first thing is the application engineer has to give us the rules actually, how the system is going to work actually. We could build the rules very easily into the system, but we need to know the rules actually. As a manufacturer or anybody who is, they have to give us the rules to build this.
Thank you.
My question. I'm Uma Prasad from BHL.
Yes,
and I think of the thing we were discussing about rule stream, and I think my colleague in BHL, I would like to answer him a little bit that, you know, we have already bought the rule stream and we are trying to implement PLM in-house, and also we are in touch with TCS and Siemens. See, you have not shown any model coming up in your demonstration.
Yes.
Okay, that ETO totally, when you seamlessly integrate with NX.
Yes.
So your PLM has nowadays interface even for electronics. So I think that portion was, coming.
Probably so I will give him a very detailed demo where how it actually talks to N number. It could talk to from 7 to 8 major CAD packages out of the box. So we even Visios, NX, and ProEs, Catia, all those stuff.
Yeah,
and you can simulate all these NX expressions to your rules in specification, so you can dynamically simulate all kinds of drawings and models.
So the templatized approach, what
yes.
you are telling, I think we would be interested to see.
Yes, sure.
And we'll interact with
it. Yes, sure. Thanks.
Good afternoon. This is Gaurav Saran from Tata Steel. My question is to Mr. Sunil from Reliance Power. You said you are using a historian for archiving your data, the real-time process data. So can you tell us up to how many years do you have that instantaneous process data? Because a day's average data or a month's average data is only for management information purpose, but for the process running or for any outage in process you want to view after 3-4 years, this instantaneous 5 minutes average or this 10 seconds data is important. So how long do you archive that data? And the second question is that data archived in the historian or using some Oracle database or other things to archive that data?
Yeah, basically if you look at real-time historians, these are all time series data, which is totally different from your other kind of database like Oracle database or something. Now, it depends on what is the interval you want to capture. Like if you are capturing some fast moving signals, like electric current, voltage, these are all what we try to do is to capture it with 1 second resolution. And some data like temperature, it may not change at all for maybe an hour. So these software, all the historian software, have got data compression techniques where it will save the data when the changes are happening. You can define those, what are the limits you want to save when if there is a change of say 2%, you will save that point. Otherwise, it will just see the old data and then extrapolate it to the next point whenever the next change comes. So this definition, this customization has to be done whenever you are taking these data and using the historians, and then you have to save according to that. For us, for Reliance Power, we have been saving it since the commissioning of the plant. The first unit of ROSA was commissioned somewhere in 2009. From that day onwards, the data is there. Whatever data has been saved in the DCS, or whatever data is acquired by the DCS, we are saving complete data, including the off-site data like DM plant, PT plant and all, where they are all connected through different PLCs to our centralized system. They are all captured and we are saving it. All these historians are capable of storing data up to years together, maybe 10, 20 years. And with a visualization software, you can go back to time and retrieve that data any moment of time without any time delay. Within seconds, you can see the data of 2 years ago, and also 2 years to three, I mean, one full data from, say, you want to see the data from 2010 to 2012. In one screen, you can see it in a, through a trend also. These are, they have got the capabilities.
Thank you, sir.
There are no more questions. I would like to thank once again all of you.